In this video, we're going to talk about selection sort. Selection sort is a way to sort ascending or descending order by selecting, by looking at a position and selecting which data goes into that position. So if you look at the screen, you'll see that I have a haystack with 5, 1, 2, 39, and so on and so forth. It's an unsorted array. So in selection sort, what we're going to do is we're going to keep looking at the list and find the value that we want to put there. So let's go ahead and take a list just like this. Okay, let's plug in some values like 3, 1, 2, and 7. So what's going to happen is we start right here. Okay, we look at 3 and we compare it to every single other element inside this list. And what we're doing is we know since we're on 1, we want to make sure that the smallest value goes in there. So it's almost like the min-max problem, where we're looking for the minimum number above this. So what we do is we start with 3. So right now the minimum is equal to 3. And what we do is we look at the next element over and we see that it's 1. Well, 1 is less than 3, so now our minimum is equal to 1. Okay. Now, generally what we want to do is we want to store what index we're looking at. So minimum value is 1, the minimum index is equal to 1. Okay. So then what we do is we move on to the next and we see that it's 2. Well, 2 is greater than 1, so we move on. And then we move on to the next one. We see that 7 is greater than 1, so we move on. So that's the first iteration of selection sort. Okay, so now what we do is now that we've looked through the entire list, we can see that the minimum value is 1. Remember, we're stuck here at 3, and we know that 3 is not in the right order. So what we do is we see that the minimum index is going to be 1, and we swap the minimum index with what we just saw. So in this case, 3 and 1 are now going to be swapped. That gives us 1, 3, 2, and 7. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to start to the next element. Okay, just like bubble sort, except the opposite, always the first element after one iteration is going to be in sorted order. After 2 iterations of selection sort, the first 2 elements are going to be in sorted order. So now we're looking at the 3 yet again. Our minimum is going to be 3 and our minimum index is going to be 1. Okay, so then what we do is we look to the right and we see that we find 2. Well, 2 is less than 3, so we change that to 2. Our minimum index is now going to be 2. Okay, so remember this is index 0, 1, 2, and 3. So then we look over at the 7. 7 is greater than 2, so we do nothing with it. Once again, when we're done with looking at the entire list, we swap 3 with whichever we found was the minimum. So that becomes 1, 2, 3, and 7. Okay, so now what we do is we start at the 3 yet again, which is the index 0, 1, 2. We look at index 2. And then what we're going to do is we're going to look at the rest of the list. So 3 is in sorted order. So our minimum is 3. Our minimum index is still 2. So nothing changed. We don't make any swaps. We do this until we're all at the very end of the list, which we are now. So 1, 2, 3, 7. Is a sorted list. So that's selection sort. So let's see how we can actually implement this using Python. So in Python, remember what we have to do. We have to look through the list twice. What we're going to do is we're going to start at the very first element. So we need a loop, a for loop that looks at the very first element. Okay, so for I in range length of the hay minus 1. So the hay is the haystack in this case. So now that we know this, what we have to do is we have to pick out, this is the index that we're going to look. So we'll call it min index is equal to I, okay? So right now, because we haven't looked at any other elements, we're now assuming that what we're looking at currently is the smallest number. Well, now we need to challenge that assumption by looking at the rest of the list. So we'll create another one. Okay, so I plus 1 will look to the adjacent element just above it. And now notice we're not going to length of minus 1, we're going to the length of the haystack itself. So now we need to make some comparisons to see what we're looking at is greater than or not. So looking at this, you can see that we have two indices, min idx, as well as range I plus 1. So what we're going to do is we're going to look at the haystack of min idx. Okay, remember we're looking for the smallest number. So if this number is bigger than the haystack at J, that means they're out of order, okay? So if the minimum index is bigger than the next thing we saw, remember the 3 versus the 1, so that means the new minimum index is going to be J, Okay. Notice we don't make any swaps until we figure out what the minimum index is going to be. So now after this for loop is completed, min idx will contain the value or the index of the smallest element. So what we have to do is we have to say, okay, if I is not equal to the min index, okay? If I is equal to the min index, that means it is already in sorted order. There's nothing we have to do. However, if it's not there, we have to do a swap. Now, if you watch the bubble sort lecture, you know this is how we're going to make a swap. There are other ways to do it. This one is the clearest way to see what's going on. It's probably not the most efficient, but it tells you what's going on. Okay, so we swap it from there. So let's take a look at what this algorithm is once again doing, and let's go ahead and run it. Okay, we run the file. We know that we have this haystack that's 51239 out of order. When we run it through selection sort, we have 11223445, and it's in sorted order. So that's the important thing to note, is that is essentially what we're going to do. Now, the reason once again that we have to do length hay minus one is because if you look here, we're actually doing I plus one. If we didn't do I minus one, that I plus one will actually get us out of the range of the elements inside there. And it will potentially crash our program because this J right here will be out of range. So there you have it, that selection sort. Thanks for watching.